Maine. It's going to be a new entertainment complex here in the Cottonwood, and we're going to talk to some of the owners of Corridors and put this whole project together. We'll meet them inside. They're still doing construction work. As you can see, we have two young people here in front of the camera, and Christopher Robin and Rebecca Riffle.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if you're not both new in the air, but Rebecca, you've been here. As a matter of fact, you were raised in Sedona, and you came here, said out camera about when you were 9 years old. So you must know a lot of people in Sedona, huh?
I do. It's a small town, so growing up, you kind of have that connection with everybody that you grew up with.
Sure.
You have that small town camaraderie between us.
You have family here?
I do.
You do? Well, that's nice.
My parents and my brother are here, and then since we've recruited a lot of other family members from the Midwest.
Well, fantastic, you know.
This way, yeah.
And what about you, Christopher? Where are you originally from?
Originally from the East Coast.
From the East Coast? What part?
Connecticut.
Connecticut, huh?
Yeah,
oh, man, way back there, huh?
What's that?
Yeah, way back in the beautiful country.
Yeah, exactly.
Actually, the Four Seasons.
Yep.
The Four Seasons.
Oh, yeah.
So are you an entertainer, Christopher, too? Are you an entertainer as far as musical or
Yeah, that's
art?
What I do for a living. I write and produce and perform.
Oh, really?
I do a lot for TV and film.
So this is all hat to you.
Yeah, that was sort of the catalyst, you know, for us collaborating on this project. That Becca had realized that there was a real need in this area, and I'm new to the area, so I've only been here about a year, and that there's a real need for a venue.
There really is, you know. This is a fantastic idea you're doing for the whole community. The whole Verde Valley really needs something like this.
Yeah.
You know, it was in dire need. They used to have one in Camp Verde, a huge club over there, but it burnt down many years ago, and I understand it was like the number one thing in the whole Yappa Pie County, you know.
Oh,
so you guys are bringing the same thing back here, something like that.
Yeah, it's gonna be a great thing. Just yesterday we had, you know, two you know, great musicians from the area here helping collaborate, and it's gonna bring a lot of people together, which is
And I think this area needs a good music hub, a good art hub.
Oh, definitely.
With a community feel that we can kind of call our own, but where musicians can really mm-hmm. work with each other, and you know, we can create some really awesome.
Do you sing too, Rebecca? No, you sing
in the shower.
In the shower.
but you write some though, huh?
I could no.
You could.
She's a literary writer.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, good.
Yeah.
And I gotta say about something about Dakota, because I just, you know, as you all both know, I had a book about it. A Doberman.
Right, yeah.
And Dakota's really a beautiful dog, and she's really well behaved.
Oh, he's incredibly behaved. I had his dad for 11 years, who was a Red Doberman.
Oh, is that right? Oh,
yeah.
So you're a Doberman lover, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Man, yeah.
Oh, absolutely. He's a Doberdor, so.
So your club is going to open when?
May 18th is our opening date, our grand opening. So we're going to have Christopher Robin Band is going to be playing.
Oh, wow.
We'll probably have a couple other bands as well, some live art going on. Some catering. It's going to be a big, fun event with a ribbon cutting happening for our grand opening around 4 o'clock.
About 4 o'clock?
Yeah. And then the festivities will begin from there.
Now May 18th, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're going to have about three bands you're performing that day, huh?
Yes.
Ribbon cutting, are you talking about some of the political people coming out here, or some of the mayor type people or something like that? Have a big newspaper press and everything like that going on?
Yeah.
Exactly.
That's fantastic. So you guys have some pretty big venues lined up in the future, huh, as far as entertainment?
We're just lining that up now.
Yeah.
We've been having to get through this whole process of putting it all together, which is
a
big process.
It's a big process. You've got to have been pretty quick. I'm going to pan the place right here and show the people some of the things you guys have been doing here lately, you know, as far as construction, you know.
Yeah, it was an empty room before.
And you really
have to come back in a few weeks and see.
Oh yeah, definitely.
See the progress.
See the progress, because there's definitely a lot going on every day, and it's going to be really, really an amazing place.
So just the two of you right now, heading the whole project up?
With Joshua Bob.
Oh yeah.
As well.
Oh, that's right. He's like a third partner.
We've had a huge help between my parents and our contractor Craig is amazing.
Oh yeah, right.
We have a lot of people involved helping out.
A lot of people. It's definitely a big career.
So Joshua lives in the area also?
Yeah, he lives down in Old Town.
Old Town?
Yeah.
But you see that you did a nice job out there in your parking lot. You extended it to about how many cars can you park out there?
About 42 now.
About 42? Oh, great. 42. That's going to be great, huh?
Yeah.
So this is actually took place in, what, in the last 3 or 4 months, all this?
Yes, since the end of January was when we finally got the green light, and it probably wasn't until the middle of
We started working on it in September.
September?
But we were very limited in what we could do. Yeah. You know, there's many city council meetings and P&Z and
All that
design review.
The city stuff. It takes
before we could actually start doing this kind of stuff.
It takes quite a dedication to get through all that.
Yeah.
But anyway, I want to talk to you, Christopher. So you're an entertainer yourself, and what kind of music do you perform?
It's what I call rock grass.
Rock grass?
It's all the elements of that make up rock and roll, southern rock and blues and aspects of gospel and country.
Oh, really?
And then you throw flat pick and bluegrass and reggae and mash it all together, and that's what I do.
Wow.
So it's, I've had a great history of being able to perform and record.
Fantastic.
And write with a lot of some of my musical heroes.
Oh, yeah, a lot of them out there, huh?
You know, from Jesse Coulter to
Taylor Jesse Coulter.
Greg Allman. And,
Waylon Jennings.
Yeah, I never got to work with Waylon, but, you know, his wife, Jesse, and I worked together for 9 years now.
Did you really?
Yeah.
You're part of the band, huh?
I was, yeah.
Is she still performing?
Not very often.
Not very often?
When she does, I'll still go out with her, but we haven't had anything since last year.
Was that right?
And that was actually her son, Shooter Jennings, who came to
I watched him perform here that last year.
And that's how I discovered this area.
And you were there?
Yeah, he invited me to
help.
I was living in Cave Creek.
Wow.
And, you know, he and I have been friends for a while, and I kind of just really dug the place.
And you wanted to get Dakota a new home.
Exactly. A place where you could run around and not be so hot. It was pretty hot in Cave Creek.
Well, Cave Creek, Phoenix area, you guys. Listen, I know you guys got 10,000 things to do, so I'm going to let you go. So I'm going to have you give out, you have a website or a phone number you want to give out or a date again when it's going to open up. Rebecca?
Opening date is May 18th, so keep checking in. We have our Facebook up at Main Stage, so from there you'll be able to access all of the information of what we have going on. So friend us on Main Stage, like us on Main Stage on Facebook.
So that, you want to give a phone number or email address or anything out right now? Or
We've got
Main Stage Theater
mainstagetheater@gmail.com.
Gmail.com,
that's basically it then?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the phone number, I haven't memorized it yet.
Nobody's answering it right now, so.
Keeps ringing the credit
really
card people.
Oh, I can imagine.
that's about
Before I let you guys go, do you want to add anything?
I'll just thank you for coming out and doing this and spreading the word out. And
we're excited, so everybody come.
And welcome the whole community out here.
Yeah, definitely.
It's gonna be a big deal once it opens. It's gonna be really an added thing to the community. Thanks a lot, you guys.
Thank you, Richard.
Have a great day, guys.
Thank you.